हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक पायलट प्लांट स्केलअप टेक्निक। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव, स्टूडेंट शुड एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड डेफिनेशन, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, स्टेप्स इन स्केलअप्स, देन जनरल कंसिडरेशन ड्यूरिंग द establishment of pilot plant, then good manufacturing practices and its consideration, then advantages and disadvantages. Definitions, that is plant, it is a place where 5 M's like money, material, man, method and machine are brought together for manufacturing of the products. Okay, means for manufacturing of any product, these 5 facilities or 5 M's are required. Then pilot plant, it is a part of pharmaceutical industry where lab scale formula is transformed into viable product by development of liable and practical procedure of manufacture. Means suppose you have one formula with you, suppose it is of your analgesic any tablet, then how can you develop or how can you modify that particular formula for the large scale production? For that purpose you should have a thorough knowledge about this formulation, manufacturing, then you should have idea about how much money is required for the large scale production, what is consistency, all these things you have to taken into the consideration and then move ahead for the large scale production. There is a correlation of R&D, that is research and development and production during the pilot plant development or during the large scale production of any laboratory formula. Then what exactly scale up? The art of designing the prototype using data obtained from pilot plant model. Why conduct pilot plant studies? A pilot plant allows investigation of product and process on intermediate scale before large amount of money are committed to full scale production. Scale up means large scale production of any product. Means you have to increase the bulk or increase your production of particular lab scale. Means first of all you have the lab formula with you, then pilot plant model is there and then scale up is there. And before, why to conduct the pilot plant studies? Because we are investing large amount of money for development of this plant, but before going this pilot plant you should have proper knowledge of that particular process, that particular pilot plant studies. It is usually not possible to predict the effect of manifold increase in scale. It is not possible to design large complex food processing plant from laboratory data alone with any degree of success. A pilot plant can be used for evaluating the result of laboratory studies, making a product and process correction and improvements, producing small quantities of product for sensory and chemical microbiological evaluation, limited market testing or furnishing samples to potential customer, shelf lives and storage stability studies, determining possible sellable byproduct or waste streaming requiring treatment before discharge. Means before going for the pilot plant study you should know these sellable byproducts which are required for your formulation or required for your product or consistent production of your product. Then which type of the waste is generated during this product development and how can you treat this waste, how can you discharge this waste. All these things you have to taken into the consideration before development of the pilot plant. Then providing data that can be used in making a decision whether or not proceed to full scale production. Okay, means the data or the knowledge you have with you, on the basis of that data you have to decide you have to proceed or not. You have to proceed for full scale production or process or not. Is it convenient? Is it suitable? Or it is beneficial or not? And in case of positive decision, designing and constructing a full size plant and modifying an existing plant. Means either you have to modify your existing plant or either you have to develop new full size plant. Consideration in pilot plant development. Kind and size. Kind means which type of the product you want to produce or which type of the formulation do you want to produce or do you want to develop. Then depends on a goal, evaluating product and process, producing samples of product for evaluation, market testing or furnishing to potential customer. Means you should have idea about the market, you should have the idea about the potential customer of your product and what is the size of that customer. It is also essential. Then location, where this pilot plant should be located. It should be near to the R&D facility, at an existing plant. Then close liaison between R&D and pilot plant staff is essential. Okay, mean there should be close interaction between the R&D and pilot plant staff. Then labor requirement and cost for the development of pilot plant, engineering staff, then skilled operations and maintenance staff are required. Then pilot plant cost may exceed those of usual plant production cost. The pilot plant may be used for training personnel for full scale plant. Means for the development of these pilot plant, you should have skilled person with you, you should have proper facility with you. You have to train your staff or train your personnel for the performing particular task. Objective of pilot plants: find mistake on small scale and make a profit on large scale. Find mistake means you have to find out the critical parameters in laboratory formula, then you have to focus on this critical parameter, you have to work on these, then you have to go for the pilot studies, pilot plant development, and you have to make your product profitable. To produce physically and chemically stable therapeutic dosage form, then review of the processing equipment, then guideline for production of process control, evaluation and validation, evaluation of product, evaluation of process, then validation of equipments, to identify critical features of process, then to develop, to provide master manufacturing formula. Master manufacturing formula is the formula is followed for the number of batches, or same formula you have to use for the number of batch production. This formula is known as the master production formula. Pilot plant studies include close examination of formula to determine its ability to withstand batch scale. Okay, means your formula should have ingredient which withstand the batch scale. Means we can produce large number of product or large number of formulation for longer period of time. There should not be any interruption, there should not be any deficiency of all ingredients. That's why its ability to withstand the batch scale. Then process modification. Process modification is required on the basis of critical parameter, which may affect the different evaluation parameters of your dosage form. Then compatibility of equipment with formulation, whether your equipment is compatible with your formulation or not, you have to study it. Then cost factor, which things are increasing or decreasing the cost of your product. Availability of raw material, meeting and specification required to produce product. Okay, which type of the raw material is available and which type of the raw material is required for you. You have to check its consistency. Then market requirement. What is customer need? You have to study it. Then physical space requirement and layout related functions. For this development of pilot plant studies, sufficient space is required and suitable layout is also required. Thus, during the scale-up effort in pilot plant, production and process control are evaluated, validated and finalized. Then product reprocessing procedure are developed and validated. Okay, means in standard operating procedure, this process are given and you have to follow it. Then different process control parameter, say for example you are or you want to produce the tablet, then we have to identify the process control parameter in this tablet development. Then you have to evaluate it, you have to validate it, and you have to finalize it. Then product reprocessing procedure are also developed and validated. Means if any problem is there in your formula, how can you reprocess it? These things you should have with you. How can you reprocess it? Which type of the procedure you have to follow? And validate these reprocessing procedures. Then appropriate record and reports are issued to support CGMP. In short, all critical features of process must be identified so that as the process is scaled up, it can be adequately monitored to provide assurance that process is under control and product produced at each level of scale-up maintain specific attributes originally intended. Means though you are using your laboratory formula and you are moving ahead toward the scale-up studies, it should have all the procedures under the control. Then the product produced at each level, it maintain the quality attributes as well as the specified attributes. There should not be any change during the large scale production during the pilot plant studies. Then design of pilot plant should support three strategic objectives, that is formulation and process development, then clinical supply manufacture, then technology evaluation, scale up and transfer. Attributes playing a key role in achieving above objectives are CGMP compliance. Means your plant design should be as per the compliance of current good manufacturing practices. Then flexible, highly trained staff, equipment and support multiple dosage form development. Means you should have such type of the equipment with you which are suitable or having the ability to support the multiple dosage form. Then equipment at multiple scale based on similar operating principle to those in production. The pilot plant design should be according to the cGMP norms. Then your plant is approved. Otherwise, it is not possible to your plant will be approved. The layout should be according to need for flexibility, that is portable equipment installed, use of multi-purpose rooms, then restricted access, then personnel flow and material flow. The facility and equipment should able to capture critical process information. Means your facility and equipment should have ability to capture this critical process parameter or process information. Then intermediate size and full scale production equipment should be available in order to evaluate the effect of scale up of research formulation. Adequate space required to carry out each function smoothly. The final decision should result in facility that support the key strategic objective and should have low maintenance and operating costs. Although pilot plant design must stimulate the manufacturing environment in which the raw new product will ultimately be produced, there are many differences in operation because of specific objective of the two types of facility. That is the pilot plant facility, product development activity, whereas manufacturing plant routinely fabricate product for the marketplace. Then steps in scale-up studies. First, define product economics based on projected market size and competitive selling, and provide guidance for allowable manufacturing cost. Means you should have the economics knowledge of your project. Then you should know the market size, then competitive selling, and provide the guidance for the allowable manufacturing cost. First of all, you have to study all these things. Then conduct laboratory study and scale up planning at same time. Then define key rate controlling steps in a proposed process. You have to identify your production process and rate controlling steps you have to define. Then conduct the preliminary larger than laboratory study with equipment to be used in a rate controlling step at aid in the plant design. Okay, we suppose you have one formula with you. You have to try it for 10x. Means suppose, do you know the formula for the one tablet? You have to try for 10 tablets and then proceed for the large scale production. Design and construct a pilot plant including provisions for process and environmental control, cleaning and sanitizing system, packaging and waste handling system, and meeting regulatory agency requirement. Means all the processes that will be happen in your pilot plant, that should be as per the norm, that should be as per the regulatory agency requirement, that is FDA or cGMP. Then evaluate pilot plant results of process and product, including process economics, to make any correction and decision on whether or not to proceed with full-scale plant development. Then general consideration, reporting responsibilities, it is R&D group with separate staffing. The formula or who developed the product can take into the product and can provide support even after transition into the production have been completed. Then personal requirement, scientists with experience in pilot plant operation as well as actual production area are most preferable means you have to prefer such a type of the scientist which is having experience or work experience in the production area, as they have understand the intent of formulator as well as understand perspective of the production personnel. The group should have some personnel with engineering knowledge as well as scale-up also involves engineering principle. The qualification required for position in a pilot plant include a blend of good theoretical knowledge of pharmaceutics and some practical experience in pharmaceutical industry. This particular person should have knowledge about theory as well as he or she should have the practical experience. In addition, ability to communicate well and ability to develop good relationship with other people are important, since experience and knowledge are most useful when adequately and effectively communicated. The number of people in the pilot plant depend upon number of product being supported and on level support required. References to 4 P's, that is personnel, premises, plant and procedure, as the essential element in the quality oriented industry. There can be no doubt of these elements. It is people that are most important actor in assurance of quality. Means among these 4 P, personnel are very important. In most cases, quality of one department affect on operation of other. For example, tablet hardness. Training. Each person engaged in manufacturing, processing, packaging, holding of a drug must receive GMP training and specific training depending on complexity of their job. Employee who require training can be categorized into 3 groups. Okay, means your employee or company employee should have thorough knowledge with the GMP. Categories of employee: new employee, then those employee who are assigned a new job, then those employee whose performance at the task falls below required, then be required for the standard. Okay, means we have to train all these 3 types of the person: those who are new, then those who are assigned for the new job. Previously he or she has a different job, now this person is assigned for the new job. Such a type of the employees required training. Then the person whose performance or task falls below this type of the person also required the training. The training of early personnel is important, since new employee may find themselves in relatively technical environment, dealing with potent or dangerous chemical and working with system of weights and measures that are unfamiliar to them. Okay, means the person who are working with potent and dangerous chemical, then working with the heavy things, that is the weights and measures, they should have the proper knowledge. Then written operation procedure are required under regulation, and they are considered helpful in an employee training program. Well documented system and standardized procedure not only help in personnel training but also provide a basis for development of self-inspection. Then space requirement for the administration and information processing, then physical testing area, then standard equipment, floor space and storage area. All these 4 types of the area or 4 types of the spaces are required in the pilot plant. Administration and information processing, you can say simply it is office space. Then physical testing area. These areas should provide permanent benchtop space for routinely used physical testing equipment. Then standard pilot plant equipment floor space. Discrete pilot space where the equipment needed for manufacturing of all type of the dosage form is located. Then intermediate sized and full scale production equipment is essential in evaluating effect of scale up of research formulation and processes. Then equipments used should made portable wherever possible. You can try to go with the small size of the equipment so that after use it can be stored in a small storeroom. Means if this particular equipment is not required for the current operation, you can keep it into the storeroom. And if size is small, then it is suitable to transfer. Space for cleaning of equipment should be also provided. Means your equipment should have sufficient space for the cleaning purpose. Then storage area. It should have two areas divided as approved and unapproved area for API as well as XDPI. You might have learned in your quality assurance subject, this storage area is full for the storage of the raw material and having two categories, that is approved and unapproved. And what exactly the difference between these two? Different area should provide for the storage in process material, finished bulk product for the pilot plant and material from experimental scale-up batches made in the production. Then storage area for the packing material should also be provided. It means all these type of the things are required, the area in your storeroom or in a storage area. Now we'll see what is the difference between approved and unapproved area. Approved area means all excipients and API sent to the quality control department. This quality control department check its specification as per our specification. If it is okay, then it is approved by the quality control department, and approved label attached with this material. And before approval, if your raw material just entered in this storage area, it is placed into the or it kept into the unapproved area. Review of formula. A thorough review of each aspect of formulation is important. The purpose of each ingredient and its contribution to the final product manufactured on the small scale laboratory equipment should be understood. Then effect of scale up using equipment that may subject the product to stresses of different types and degrees can more readily be predicted or recognized. Then raw material. One purpose or responsibility of pilot plant is approval and validation of API and excipient and raw material. As I told you, your raw material should be approved from the quality control department, because raw material used in a small scale production cannot necessarily be representative for large scale production. Then ingredients may change in particle size, then shape or morphology, which results in differences in bulk density, then static charges, then rate of solubility, flow property and color. Okay, these are the different factors which may change because of the unspecified or improper raw material. Then equipments. Most economical and the simplest and efficient equipment which are capable of producing product within the proposed specification are used. The size of equipment should be such that the experimental trial run should be relevant to the production size batches. If the equipment is too small, process developed will not scale up. Whereas if equipment is too big, then wastage of the expensive active ingredients is there. Means you have to select such a type of the equipment which are most economical, simple to use, then it is having more efficiency to produce particular product, then it should require the less space, then production rate. It can be determined by intermediate future market requirement. Then equipment and processes should be chosen on the basis of production of batch at the frequency that takes into consideration product loss in equipment during manufacturing, then the time required to clean the equipment between batches, the number of batches that will need to be tested for release. All these three things affect the production rate. Means how much amount of product loss is there during completion of one batch, then what, how much time is required for the cleaning of from the one batch to second and next batch, then number of batches that will need to be tested for release, then process evaluation, which type of the process parameter you have to evaluate. For example, mixing speed, then mixing time, rate of addition of granulating agent or solvent, then solution of drugs, then heating and cooling rate, then filter size, then screening size, drying time and drying temperature, then order of mixing of component. These things you have to take into the consideration during the validation of process or during the evaluation of process. Why to carry out the process evaluation? The knowledge of the effects of various process parameters, as a few mentioned above, form the basis for product process optimization and validation. Okay, means which parameter is having what type of the effect, you should know. That's why you have to evaluate the process. It is the basis of process validation. Documentation of process is to be done. Process is validated only if there is no change in formula, quality of ingredient or equipment configuration. Then revalidation need to be done to ensure that changes have not take place. Then master manufacturing procedures. There are three important aspects, that is the wet sheets, processing direction and manufacturing procedure. The wet sheet should clearly identify the chemical required in batch. To prevent confusion, the names and identifying numbers for ingredient should be used on a batch record. Means which type of the chemicals are required. Suppose you want to prepare the one batch of the tablet of paracetamol, then which type of the chemicals required and in how much amount it required, it is mentioned into the wet sheet. The process direction should be precise and explicit. The manufacturing procedure should be written by actual operator. Various specification like addition rate, mixing time, mixing speed, heating and cooling rate, then temperature, storing of finished product, sample should be mentioned in batch record direction. Okay, batch record direction means, suppose you want to prepare 10,000 tablets, and for that 10,000 tablet you have to prepare the batch manufacturing record. Then in that batch manufacturing record, you should have to mention everything, still from the raw material to the evaluation of your tablet. Everything you have to mention, and you have to took the sample in between your production process. You have to evaluate it and its results obtained from the quality control department. You have to mention it into the batch manufacturing record. Then product stability and uniformity. primarily objective of pilot plant is physical as well as chemical stability of product. Okay, means your product should be physically and chemically stable. Hence, each pilot batch representing a final formulation and manufacturing procedure should be studied for stability. Stability studies should be carried out in finished package as well. Hence, you have to determine the stability study, or you have to determine for the how much period of time your formulation is remain stable. Then you can calculate expiry date of your formulation by performing stability study or accelerated stability study. Then after completion of your production process, even though you have your finished product with you, still you can perform the stability study of that finished product. Next part is the GMP consideration. Equipment qualification, process validation. Equipment qualification means you have to install it, that is installation qualification, then operational qualification, then performance qualification. Everything should be as per the equipment or as per the requirement of that particular equipment qualification. When you purchase a new equipment, these IQ, OQ, PQ, not IQ, OQ and PQ given by the particular manufacturing company. Different parameters are given in this operational and performance qualification. Just we have to perform the task and mark it as OK. Means your equipment is working properly. Then process validation. Each and every process used into the manufacturing of product, it should be validated. Then regularly scheduled preventive maintenance. You have to determine how can you take the preventive measures for particular process. Then regularly process review and revalidation. Relevant written standard operating procedure. For you use of your equipment, you should have to follow the SOP, that is standard operating procedure. Then the use of complete technically qualified personnel, adequate provision for the training of personnel. If you are changing the job of one person from one department to another department, then he or she should be trained for that particular department. A well-defined technology transfer system, then validated cleaning procedure. Okay, cleaning procedure also you have to validate. An orderly arrangement of equipment as to ease of material flow and prevent cross-contamination. Okay, means you should have the equipment arrangement in a such a way that uniform flow of the material should be there. Means suppose you have storeroom or storage area with you, then you have to proceed for the next equipment. Suppose material entered into the manufacturing area, then immediately suppose you have the tablet plant with you, there should be the sifting equipment. Okay, sifter should be there. Then granulator should be there. Then hot air oven should be there, or tray dryer should be there. Then you have to proceed for the next operation. Means arrangement of your equipment, it should be in a proper manner, and because of these proper arrangement of the equipment, there is no cross contamination of material. Then advantages. Members of production and quality control division can readily observe scalabrance. Supplies of excipients and drugs cleared by quality control division can be drawn from the more spacious area provided to the production division. Access to engineers department personnel is provided for equipment installation, maintenance and repair. Then disadvantages: the frequency of direct interaction of formulator with production personnel in a manufacturing area will be reduced. Any problem of manufacturing will be directed towards its own pilot plant personnel. This is all about the pilot plant scale-up study. Thank you.